Katung, representing the people of Zangon Katav and Java Federal Constituency. I'm from the urban state of Kaduna. I rise to move on a motion pursuant to Order 8, Rule 4, a matter of urgent public importance, on the urgent need to revive the textile industries in Nigeria, with particular reference to Kaduna and Kano axes. I want the House to consider the matter urgent and to suspend all relevant rules to enable me to take this motion. Thank you.
My friend, that the matter is very urgent that it should be heard.
Those in favor of the motion say aye. Those against it say nay. The ayes have it. Honorable Katung, can you now move your motion, please?
The motion is on the urgent need to revive the textile industries in Nigeria, with particular reference to Kaduna and Kano axes, inclusive of Aba. The House notes that the Nigerian textile industry blossomed in the 60s and 70s following committed government interventionist schemes, such as the ban on importation of textiles, which ultimately drove many investors into the sector. The House also notes that Kaduna was referred to as the textile city because it housed giant integrated mills and had the headquarters of the Nigerian Textile Manufacturers Association. Then the state could actually boast of about 11 textile companies, including the Arewa Textiles, PLC, Fantex, Nortex, United Nigerian Textiles, providing employment and business opportunities to thousands of people. Aware that the Kaduna Textile Limited, one of the oldest mills in the country, was established in 1957, shut down in 2002, with its over 7,000 employees laid off and its once admirable structure now a shadow of itself. Concerned that today, though there are local textile companies trying to rear their voices with various designs and fabrics in the Nigerian market, we cannot feign ignorance of the fact that there is still a wide gap that needs to be filled in the Nigerian textile industry. Further concerned that it is undeniable that the lost glory is yet to be restored, as presently it is even hard to believe that the Nigerian textile industry once occupied an enviable spot of being the third largest in Africa in the 1980s, generating as much as $2 billion annually, and with a capacity of producing more than 1.4 billion different pieces of textile products, including African prints, shirting, bed sheets, furnishing fabrics, towels, embroidery, lace, table and bed linen, guinea brocades, wax prints, Java prints, jutes, and fishing nets. Worried that despite the introduction of an industrial revolution plan aimed at revamping and fast-tracking the growth and development of the cotton textile and garment sector and addressing the various problems facing it, it is obvious that at the moment, one of the most daunting challenges is the influx of foreign textiles into the country. Further worried that with the temporary lifting of the ban on textile importation in 2010, Nigeria has almost 80% of its textiles imported from China, Indonesia, Taiwan, and other countries. This trend is definitely not helping the Nigerian economy in terms of employment, job creation, and needed foreign exchange.
Chair rules.
The House therefore resolves to call on the federal government, the Federal Minister of Agriculture, and Federal Minister of Trade and Commerce as a matter of urgency to ensure the revival of the textile industries in Nigeria, with particular reference to Kaduna and Kano axes and Aba, as this will further create job opportunities to the unemployed population of our country. Two, to urge the Nigerian Customs Service to increase surveillance of our borders to check the activities of smugglers and ensure collection of the right tariffs for all imported textiles and other related produce. Three, the need to include a special intervention fund in the 2017 budget to facilitate the early revival of the sector. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.
Seconder will be Honorable Bashir Babale.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker.
Well, the only thing I'm going to add is a few statistics so that members will appreciate what is happening and going on in the industry. If we look at between 1985 and 1991, the textile sector had an annual growth rate of 67%. with about 180 textile mills in operation. And recently, according to a leadership newspaper report of October 17, 2015, titled The Pathetic Story of North's Textiles Industry, at the peak of operations, 8 factories in Kaduna employed about 30,000 workers. And 18 factories in Kano, as of 1995, employed about 120,000 workers. Most of these factories today are lying idle. I spoke to one of the textile manufacturers in Kano, a private entrepreneur, yesterday, and he said to me, at the peak of the industry, he employed over 600 people. As of today, he's employing about 30 people and barely able to run a shift. I said, before 1992, Kaduna and Kano states were the haven of textile producers in the north. Kano at the time could boast of about 8 mills that employed 30,000. The mills mostly located at the industrial hub employed so many workers, and cotton production too was on the increase because there were people ready to buy cotton. There's a long chain involved in this, in the textile production, from cotton production to weaving to transporters, marketers, up to the textile industry. It's an industry that is capable of getting Nigeria out of the woods in terms of export, conserving foreign exchange, and creating needed employment. Thousands of workers of textile industries located in Kano and Kaduna have lost their source of income and are forced to live without entitlements as a result of the crash of the industries. There are diverse theories on the cause of the slump of the textile industries in Nigeria, with the north being the worst hit. One of the most popular is the influx of cheaper products from China and Taiwan. There's need for a deliberate policy by the government to check this influx so as to conserve our foreign exchange, like I stated earlier. And the Nigerian army has taken a step recently. The government needs to come up with a policy to deliberately insist that Nigerians must patronize local textiles. That is the only way our textile industries can grow. In the Punch editorial of yesterday, which with the kind permission of Mr. Speaker, I'll read, he said the recent decision of the Nigerian army to buy some of their kits locally is the strongest indication yet that the ongoing campaign to conserve scarce foreign exchange by patronizing made in Nigeria goods is gaining traction, even among government institutions. The next logical step now would be for the government to come up with an official policy to compel the procurement departments of all public institutions to give preference to locally manufactured goods whenever they make their purchases. It says the campaign of the National Economic Summit Group to encourage the patronage of made in Nigeria goods will amount to nothing if the local manufacturers are not empowered to meet the needs of the Nigerians, both quantitatively and qualitatively. And finally, but for the ingenuity of Nigerians to fully flourish, the government has to provide an enabling environment, especially in the area of infrastructure provision and policy direction. A lot is expected in the area of ease of doing business, where Nigeria currently ranks a dismal low of 169 out of 180 countries. Without a conducive environment, economic growth and foreign investment will remain a fleeting illusion to be pursued but never achieved. Mr. Speaker, my honorable colleagues, I urge us to support this motion and endorse it with the speed of light, as Honorable Osai would say. Thank you very much.